It is amazing to have two researchers from NSSL win the Presidential Early Career Award for Scientists and Engineers. These awards are given out to very few people across the United States. It's a very prestigious award that is both humbling and exciting at the same time. One of NOAA's key strategic goals is to increase the lead time for severe weather warnings. And Pam has been very much involved in leading the use of radar data to improve warning lead times.
After completing my degree, I've worked in dual polarization. I've also worked with a number of radar applications. And then perhaps even more interesting to me than those has been a development in phased array radar. And that's what I've been working on for the past few years. One of the unique things about that radar is that it's electronically steered rather than mechanically steered. And what that means is that we can focus the radar beam wherever we want without having to collect data in a set pattern. And so I've been looking at, the impact then on what we see within storms, both from a scientific understanding perspective and a applications understanding, say as a forecast warning person, how that might that kind of data help, say, improve the tornado warning lead time.
Because of all the unique organizations within the National Weather Center, we have really interesting opportunities for collaborating. And Mike is a key piece in terms of developing and expanding our collaborations.
I've been working with people at the NOAA Severe Storms Lab and also the NOAA Storm Prediction Center to evaluate high-resolution numerical models and to work with researchers and forecasters together in one setting to evaluate these experimental products and to bring cutting-edge research to the forecast side of things. And for me, I'm a forecaster at heart, so I enjoy sitting down and producing forecasts side by side by people who do it for a living, and that's always very fulfilling for me.
Mike is very enthusiastic about trying to learn how severe weather develops and evolves.
I think in the next several years, high-resolution numerical models are going to be used much more in a forecast setting. That's something that us at NOAA NSSL, through the Hazardous Weather Testbed, have been experimenting with the last several years, and how to best use them and to work with forecasters to try to extract the best information we can out of them to improve forecasts.
Pam is very actively involved in mentoring and growing our next generation of scientists. And so she works with both undergraduate and graduate students.
And so with undergraduates, they come for the summer and you have the opportunity to work with them on a well-defined project and help them understand what research, is all about. And I also now work with graduate students. I'm helping them to do a more full-fledged research project and to help them develop those skills that they need to understand research and be able to do it on their own. And it's fun to watch them grow.
Vortex 2 is a field experiment to learn about how tornadoes form, and Mike was very involved with it.
My experience with Vortex 2 was initially helping to set up the Vortex Operations Center here at NSSL and the different forecasting products that we'll provide to support Vortex. And then for the final 2.5 weeks, I was out in the field and actually got a taste of what it's like to forecast on the front lines for that. And it was an incredible experience and one that I hope to repeat again next year.
I think these awards really emphasize how important our work is to the nation. These awards show us that the work we're doing is relevant and important, and we're very much involved with saving lives and helping people when severe weather strikes.
This award is quite an honor for me. It means a lot to have my research efforts, my leadership acknowledged, and to have the opportunity, then to be able to talk about it and, share what I've been doing and, the importance of what I'm doing, relative to NOAA, to NSSL, you know, as well as to, you know, the people who in the public, you know, that I think we also impact by what we do.
This award means a great deal to me. It's great to be recognized among outstanding scientists in the government from around the country, and especially because it's awarding something that I've worked so hard to achieve in a field that doesn't even feel like work to me, so it means a lot to me.